Hey, welcome to the 6-Inch Show, episode number 35. My name is Fly Guy, and I'm joined as usual by Matt from Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries and many other places. Good evening, sir. How are you?
I'm good. I'm hot, but I'm good.
Hot and sticky. Yes, it's very hot and sticky where we are. Not just your host hot and sticky, but the temperature is hot and sticky. We also, terrible segue, we have a bunch of stuff for you tonight to cover. Marvel, Hasbro, Star Wars, all the usual. A little bit of Japanese going on there with some very unusual figures from the Orient. We'll get some customs. We got some awesome toy photography. So go grab yourself a drink or something, and we will take you through all the news that we've got to cover. First things first, the last episode, 34, as usual. Thank you very much to everybody who joined and watched and commented on the show. There was a lot of comments checking. There never seems to go a week where we don't seem to cover the whole topic of SHF or Black Series. It never seems to go away. So we had some interesting comments on 34. I'm just going to bring up those. Thank you again, as I said, to everybody who commented on the show. Let me just have a look at the comments as we discuss. As my machine just freezes up. What did we have? We had quite a few people talking about Darth Vader. I remember we were talking about Darth Vader at some point in that show. Merry Christmas to people. Happy New Year. There's lots of seasonal greetings as we went on. Kenny Crayley, always the same. And a lot of UK people as well. They were replying to some of the prices and some of the figures they'd seen at discounting in their stores. So, yeah, look, thank you to everybody who watched 34, nearly 1,000 of you so far. Thank you, guys. But always good fun. I don't think there was anything really controversial that came out of that, but it seems like forever that was Christmas time we were doing that show. So, yeah, long time ago. Anyway, first things first, Grievous is one of the figures that went up for sale since we last did a show. And since then, I don't know if you'd noticed this, Matt, but his cape's changed.
Yeah.
Did you know about this?
I noticed during or something during, like I didn't notice in the first day or two, and it wasn't before people pointed it out, but I just noticed it wasn't as shiny. It's like we've gone from silk to kind of shitty Velcro tracksuit. I don't know.
So, yeah, it's a very weird one. There's, let me just go through. I picked it up here. And it was only when I was on Dorkside's site that I noticed the images, as we said there. So there's the, and we already covered this in the recap, but just, so there's the product pack shot we're getting. So we've got this cloth, as you said, tracksuit-like kind of cover. They've included, and there's the pack shot. So we know that's what we're getting in the box. And a close-up there, you can clearly see this is all how this is put together. Not looking really that good there. But when you go in the next photograph, there we go. He had a very different cape.
But what I'm not sure of, and now I'm thinking it's going to take me too long to scroll and find it, but if we go back to the kind of display shots from New York Comic Con, what cape did you have?
That's a good point. That's a good point.
Because that's what I'm not sure about now that we're talking about it. But look, a couple of things. I think that no matter what kind of cape it is, if you can tuck it under the
neck,
it'll look better. Yep. And secondly, if the silk one is gone and it's the tracksuit one, there's going to be a whole heap of talented mini tailors who do a lot more complicated customs than it will to make a cape for Grievous.
Yep. I think this was just glam. Yeah, this was StarWars.com. Glam shots, the same ones all the press got.
I will scroll whilst we're talking and see if I can find it. And if it's worth mentioning, then we'll find the image. I'm going for people's pics on their feeds from actually being at Comic-Con.
Like, oh, there you go. On the table. It was tracksuit.
Yeah, that's...
Ah.
But again, I think there was some people eventually got shots of the tracksuit one at Comic-Con tucked under the breastplate and it looked much better. Because I think on the first day they did the round tables, they had the cape positioned like that. And then when they opened up the Hasbro stand,
right,
they put it on properly and it looked much better.
Yep. because it really does look quite different there.
It's
you know, really beautifully done. But however, Jason and I were talking about this, just as we were talking about, we looked at some kind of stills from Revenge of the Sith and other scenes where he's in, and that is the wrong color to keep. It is a much lighter gray, that tracksuit looking color. But we still, neither of us could remember whether there'd ever been a shot of the back of the cape to see whether it had that kind of his house emblem or whatever it was. Almost looks like a Mandalorian symbol in some ways. So I don't know if anybody knows out there, anybody who's watching, let us know what you think. I know it's hardly the most exciting thing in the world, but you know, I want to know what's on the other side of his cape. So, and I don't think we've seen a shot yet. So yeah.
I'm going to say I'm also surprised if they're doing their retail shots and we've got the original black background glam shots. Now we've got the white retail glam shots that we've still never seen the figure with two arms. It's always been the forearm version. It's like, why is there no picture of them clipped together? Because it was said at New York Comic Con that the arms do clip in as two and they separate as four kind of thing. And
yep.
Surely, if you're going to have one image, two images, we've seen certain things have five wide images or four wide images. Why isn't there an image of Grievous with these two arms as opposed to four, always four?
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yeah, it's a good question. We need to see more about Grievous. But anyway, since we were last on, the pre-order went up. So it's available at fan channels. So that's Dorkside, BBTS, Entertainment Earth, those places. Going to be very popular, this figure. I would really think get in there and not muck around. It's not going to be at your Targets. It's not going to be at Walmart's. It is going to be bizarrely be at GameStop's because that's considered a fan channel, which I still don't understand. But I wouldn't imagine in massive quantities. So, yeah, a popular figure, that is for sure. But, yeah, time will tell. We're going to get to see it soon enough. So, yes, interesting.
Just something that's come up in the last week, and it came up with the announcement of, which we can talk about, I guess, Zuckuss and Phasma.
Absolutely.
Becoming now available beyond the Disney store to the fan channels again, the Dorksides, the BBTS, the Entertainment Earth, and I'll throw in Empire Toy Shop as well because they're stocking them. But a lot of American collectors keep going, oh, you can just get it from Disney online kind of thing. It's like, yeah, I'm sure you can, but if you're international collectors, you can't. So
correct.
This fan channel thing does open it up to Australia and the UK and New Zealand.
Yep.
It's just a different game for us who aren't American based, and this fan channel thing is so much more advantageous to us than it is to having a Target exclusive or a Walmart exclusive or whatever it is. And again, American collectors, if you can get it on Disney, go for it. Somebody was pointing out that UK has a Disney store, but again, once they checked it, the UK Disney store does not offer these figures online. So the fan channel thing is the greatest solution.
I agree.
The biggest problem that plagues international collectors.
Yeah. I think it pisses a lot of the US guys off because the not everybody, there's plenty of people, for example, a couple of people I know that stay in the kind of New York area. And if you've ever been to New York City, there's no Walmart in New York City. There's a tiny, tiny, dinky little Target, which is always scalped to death.
Walgreens, but they are
people. Exactly. Yeah, exactly. So
they're all just small pharmacies without.
Exactly. So there's plenty of people who can't get Walmarts. I mean, again, somebody was talking about the vintage collection 3.75 and all the Walmart stuff. And again, they couldn't find it. They don't have stores. So it's not just, you know, global people. It's people in the US too. But look, anywhere that you can go on and order it online and get it delivered, I think is a fantastic thing. And I think Hasbro's slowly but surely waking up to this fact. It took them bloody long enough with Toys R Us and all that kind of stuff. And I think it's a little bit easier for them. If they can just ship it to one gigantic warehouse, done. If they've then got to ship it to multiple online, you know, BBTS, Dorkside, EE, Empire, as you said, all these places, it's just more work for them. So I think that was why they were reticent to do it. But sorry, guys, it's easier for us and we're the customer. So suck it up. Yeah, but really nice that you can be able to get these exclusives. And I think it also shows, you and I were talking about this earlier on, that, look, just our opinion, I think, and I think you were of the same mind as me, but there's a bunch of stuff that Hasbro's now soliciting to fan channel stores. And I think a good indication is because they've not been selling at the exclusive stores. Disney stores, there's not that many of them. Whether you like it or not, not a lot of people buy from the Disney store online for the figures we're talking about. Sure, for Frozen dresses and, you know, kids wearing Chewbacca masks, probably, but not, I don't think, for these kind of figures.
And I think the other thing that I see from, you know, all the way back here in Sydney, is when you look at a Target exclusive like the Gamorrean Guard, it is, what do you call it? It's either, they're either flushed with too many, or areas just saying, we never got it. So it's like,
yeah, sure.
The Gamorrean Guard, I've seen photos even in recent weeks of like 20 of them at a Target in wherever it is. And then I'll just read comments further and further from major cities and states, et cetera, going, and I'm just making this up now, but never seen one in Texas kind of thing. And it's like, well, it's so uneven if they get 20,000 of them and they're hitting certain areas and then missing states completely.
Mm-hmm.
It's not really an exclusive that's available to, if you're lucky enough to have a Target near you, even then it's potluck. Fan channels, everyone from every state in America and pretty much every country in the world,
correct,
in reason, has a shot at it, and you'll sell more units.
I know.
Simple. It's really simple for Hasbro, I think, in shifting units, is to make it available to everyone who wants one.
I know. Well, as I said, I think it's just, it's making life a little bit more complex for them. But, well, do you know what? Just deal with it. Get on with it. Give wider distribution. It's always been an issue. Every time I've ever met Hasbro face-to-face or even in email communications, that if we've had them, distribution's always the number one issue that people always complain, I can't find, or we've got too many, or, I mean, it's just, you know, or case pack assortments. So, yeah, I'm liking this. This is really, really good. So there's good things coming out of Toys R Us imploding, I think. So, yeah, there's plenty of figures. Zuckuss, as we said, Phasma and Grievous. So go get your figures, as well as the archive figures as well. So there's plenty of cool Star Wars stuff to be purchasing. Talking of archive, slight segue there. We got a little post from Jason at Yakface today. His rumor report. We knew all these. Anakin Skywalker, Yoda, the Baker Scout, Darth Maul. We knew that was kind of coming anyway. So those four are the next in the Wave 2 for the Black Series. And he supplied some codes should you need them. If you're buying them online, then you don't really need them, so it doesn't matter. But as I was asking the question, Wave 3, what's going to come in Wave 3? What's your bets?
Now, what was my bet?
I think we did talk about this before.
Yeah, so I'm lost, but I think that... I think it's still going to come from the... we're kind of moving into the blue wave now.
Mm.
Every possibility that Han Solo's Stormtrooper might be in there because of Wet Luke, or they might save him for Wave 4 or something.
Wet Luke.
Photo real face. But I think Commander Cody will be in a,
yep,
be
an archive
figure.
I agree.
Oh, you'll probably get...
what do you think about the Luke Bespin?
I think Luke Bespin will be there because I think he'll then... If he's not there in the archive, he'll be there in the vintage 40th anniversary. I think we're going to get a couple of Bespin in the next 2 years.
Mm.
If they're, I'm not going to say if they're smart, but if they are smart, it's now time for Phase 2 White Cloak Trooper to come out as an archive figure in the same way that the Scout Trooper did.
Mm.
Because only available in that 4-pack, what was it, an Amazon 4-pack?
Mm-hmm.
The Amazon 4-pack and... It's a glaring omission. Like, you need everyone needs a white trooper. Like,
yep.
I guess the other archive ones could be any of the other colored clone phase one clone troopers, maybe the Emperor.
Yeah, I think that's one that's definitely needed. But again, it's how far they go with the archive to improve them and add extras. For example, he's got a cane, but he has no "you will die" scary face with the, you know, the hands. And that's just a glaring omission to me that suggests a carded or other kind of re-release.
Look, I reckon I've said it before that Jedi Luke Skywalker should be a deluxe whatever figure, and the other one that should be a deluxe. I mean, I'd take a $30, as I've said a million times, a $30 deluxe Jedi Luke Skywalker, cape, multiple yep. hands, multiple gloves, ungloved, damaged hand, all those versions, whether you put the Endor equipment in there or not, whatever, but tunic, no tunic, all that stuff, $29, I'll do it. $30 yep. US, I'll do it like a Grievous. Yep. I think the Emperor's the other one who needs it because
yep.
within the deluxe XL version, he has his black cloaks and his red cloaks. So he's got his lightsaber and his cane and lightning.
He's also got a throne.
And, yeah.
That would just be, you know, like Snoke was in some ways. Yeah. Interesting.
Like, I mean, so if you skip him from the archive line, bring him into the XL line and actually... like with my dream Luke Skywalker, XL Luke, whatever it is, recast him, reshape him, because the archive's like, it'll be the same thing, but just photo reel.
Yeah.
Recast him, make a new one, make a better one, because, again, 6 years later, we're doing stuff better.
So, yeah, that's true. That's true.
But red cloak and black cloak, lightsaber and lightning, cane, and maybe a chair. But, you know, he's begging for something more.
Exactly. Well, if you're watching this show, tell us, what do you think? What's your four that you think for Archive Series 3? Leave a note in the comments below underneath the video, which is, by the way, where I should say all the links to the stuff we cover tonight, including Matt's toy photography site, is under the video. So check it out there. But tell us what you think is Series 3 for the Archive Wave.
I just had a brainwave. So what is it? We've got, I say Cody.
Cody, I agree.
Leia Bosk. Well, not Bosk, Boosh, Bausch, Boosh.
Boosh. Yes. Yes, I agree with that.
We should get a Leia slave layer, but I think that's gone. So let's just go with Bounty Hunter Leia. And Cody, and throw in some clones, other clones or something, if we're not gonna get an Emperor.
I really do hope we get a slave layer again. It just is a giant FU to the pains in the ass that took great offense at it. I just think it's just like, get bent. It's just, yeah, I don't know. It's like the recent Gillette nonsense. It's like, give me a break.
But I think, anyway. I do, last off thing I'll say about the archive, I know that it's about not changing the sculpts, but giving better paint apps to them all and photoreal technology. But if X-Wing Luke has taught us one thing, you're going to sell out of whatever you make. And if 90% of the body is... already sculpted and you just change the head and you can improve it, you could even add another 20,000 units. Everyone's going to buy the new version of whatever. And I know that's not a double dipping thing, but when you get to a slave layer and you've absolutely nailed Carrie Fisher.
Sure.
And I've seen the customs where people are now doing it to nearly every layer figure. Mm. Cutting the Hoth layer head and joining it to a new yep. Hope layer or joining it to slave layer, you've got the sculpt there at the moment now. So yeah, you're making a new head, but you're not actually re-sculpting it. You've got the face and the photoreal paint app.
Yep.
You're just putting a new head on the back or the old head on the back and joining it together. The archive line, we don't want to see a re-release in the red and black pack. So we should see an improved sculpt or new head put onto certain archive line figures.
Yeah. And there's every chance we could get Leia again. Just I'm sure we'll get a much more PC name like Jabba's Prisoner or something.
I like what did Carrie Fisher call it? Hutt Slayer.
Yes, exactly. That's a really good one. That's a very good one. But yeah, leave a note underneath the video. Let us know your four archive wave three. that's it for Star Wars, I think. Moving on to Marvel and other general six-inch news. New Spidey trailer appeared. Not really related to figures, but we may get figures, so there's a thin, thin link. What did you think? Did you, have you watched it yet?
Yeah, I watched it today. I thought it was awesome.
It's really good. Mysterio. What do you think of Mysterio being a potential good guy?
Yeah, I don't mind. It works either way, but it's the kind of idea that we get. First thing we see of Mysterio is Jake Gyllenhaal's face. It's like...
No. It's kind of bizarre.
And it's Jake Gyllenhaal. So yeah, it looks cool. You know, obvious things that I'm sure Kevin Feige would have been... I've actually read that he would have been happier that Sony didn't put a trailer out because there's Nick Fury and there's Spider-Man.
Yeah, I know.
Kind of thing. It's kind of like, oh, and they're back.
I know.
So whatever it is, there's that. But I also noticed that there was an international and a US, or a kind of, how would you say it, a...
different trailer?
Yeah, well, two different beginnings and two different endings. And the different ending was literally changing kind of, you know, Flash Thompson going, I like Spider-Man. He looks after the city. He looks cool and everything. Hey, what's up, asswipe? Kind of thing to Peter Parker. And the other one's like, hey, Dick, what's Ward. Up, jerk? Or dickwad or whatever. And
did they change
like,
it?
That's... Yeah, I saw one for the IMAX, which was like, hey, what's up, dork? Or something like a really generic thing to get rid of dickwad kind of thing. So
okay.
That's but, yeah, that's good. I like the black suit. I like the...
Looks very kind of Spider-Man noir. It was kind of weird. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Some good figures, I think, could come from that. The chances of obviously getting a Mysterio movie version is obviously quite high as well, I think.
Yeah.
Maybe. So, yeah. More figures, more Marvel movies. 3 Marvel movies, I think, this year.
That's quite a lot. Spider-Man, Avengers, and...
There's one other one. I can't remember what it is.
Captain Marvel.
Captain Marvel, thank you. Yes, in March. And they're all the beginning of the year, so Marvel-tastic time is going to be had. So, yes, very cool Spidey trailer. What did you think of the trailer, peeps? Let us know in the comments. Something that popped out, caught my eye just the other day, was this pretty stunning figure, which when you translate the text from Japanese... says dignified entrance ! And it's a Yamaguchi Iron Man, and it's quite a stunning figure. I'm sure you saw images of this as well. Look at this thing. It's just nuts. The articulations, as usual with kind of Yamaguchi and other Japanese figures, just insanely well done. But look at the accessories we get here. Now, I think this is just about 6 inches or just under, but I thought I'd include it regardless. But amazing poses. As usual, all Japanese figures really come with a stand. So it just makes it incredibly presentable. Every piece of articulation you could think of is happening here. And I don't see too many big joints. It doesn't seem to be too much of an issue. Nice feature there. I mean, that's something Hasbro could easily do for figures as a bit of a change. But we don't really get that kind of stuff. That's why I do love some of these figures. They look so, so cool. And the poses kind of put Hasbro to shame from some of the dodgy photographs we get of Hasbro products sometimes, the toy photography. As you and I have commented before, like, what were they doing in that pose? But these guys get it absolutely right. So very, very cool figure. So more details coming soon. Probably going to be retailing around $70 US, I think. But that pose alone, just I thought, my God, that's so, so cool. So please, go ahead.
I was going to say we'll get to it when we look at some photos. But what's been hitting my feet on the Toy Tribe side has been the Mezco Classic Iron Man suit. Like, I mean, I don't know whether we covered it when it was announced and whatever else, but it's kind of, for me, it's kind of new in the sense of being hit with it by people's toy photography, and even that itself has great posing kind of thing, just in comparison. But, yeah.
Do you have any picks up in your Toy Tribe or?
Yeah, I've got one or two shots of, I think, the classic Iron Man with the SH Figure Arts Hulk on one, and then I think I've got another one somewhere. I think I've got one of Dorkler's shots of it.
Okay, we'll have a look at that once we...
Yeah.
That'd be cool to see. Another Japanese figure that has been doing the rounds, just literally today, I saw this popped up on Amy News. Once this page loads and it translates, the Figma Goblin Slayer. Now, again, normally 6 inches. This is quite an unusual looking figure. Kind of mythic, I've probably got the name wrong, Mythic Legions.
Yeah.
Legions and that kind of stuff. It just caught my eye as something that looked pretty nice. Again, comes with a stand. As Figma, I'm always on the stands. But just really nice looking articulation, just different, something different in that scale. Probably not the most, there we go, it's a much better looking picture, but lots of nice weathering and detail on the figure too. So trying to branch out a little bit, just to show you that there are other 6-inch figures out there. I know we focus a lot on Hasbro because we love them, but yeah, just showing you some other stuff, articulated toes going on there. But yeah, an unusual character, not related to any game that I know of or anything that I can see in the translation there, but again, tons of articulation. Does have those big ball joints, but still, you know, if you want to into that kind of thing, then there you go. So a little bit more is up on Amy. They've got images of every aspect there. No purchase details yet, but there you go. We will find out more soon. That was that. What else did we have in this side? Well, there was a bit more Hasbro that came around. We'll get to the new stuff because there was a lot of new figures that launched very early in January. But this was one, and I'm sure you saw it too. Mike De La Paz, otherwise known on Instagram as Phoenix Force Creations, did this stunning shot of a before and after of a Captain Marvel. There's the Infinity War figure there, the straight-out-of-the-box Hasbro version, which really wasn't great. It was pretty lackluster. And yeah. Admittedly, you can see something.
I was just going to say, not only was it lackluster, like, I mean, it wasn't hard to get shaggy hair. Yeah. Captain America kind of thing. It was like a short crop. No, we don't care.
Yeah, it just didn't. I know. Something about it didn't work at all. Look, Mike De La Paz is a genius and spent considerable amounts of time painting this, just as it does for some of the other people that we've covered, Old Boy CTTS and others. They spent a lot of time, and you know, when you buy a replaceable head from them, it's more than the figure in many cases. So I think there's a lot of people still, they left a lot of comments just saying, you know, why can't Hasbro do this? And it's outrageous and Hasbro shit. And it's like, yeah, but remember they're doing it for $21.99 at retail price. So you got to take that into consideration. And things like this are normally in the kind of SHF or $70-$80 price mark. So if that, with that quality, to be honest.
And also, I'm not sure how many, but let's call it
exactly
30, 40, 50, 60, 70,000 of them, not 40 of them or 20 of them or 10 of them.
Yeah, exactly. So you got to put apples with apples and kind of compare the things. So, but still, pretty damn stunning. And that is Chris Evans, without a doubt. So nice, nice job. Nice, nice baby. While we were enjoying New Year, some figures, as I said, went up for sale. I know you ordered some of these. We got a lot of figures go up. X-Men Rides, or X-Men Professor X in his chair, hover chair, and Deadpool Corpse with Dogpool, Squirrelpool, etc. So that went up, and you can order that if you want. And while we were off it as well, Captain Marvel went up, and Spidey Kingpin go up before then?
Was
that Christmas time? Can't remember.
Maybe anyway, it went up before our last show.
I think it did.
Yeah.
Anyway, definitely Captain Marvel. So, yeah. So,
and Kingpin started shipping. The Kingpin
was. Yeah, exactly. Kingpin, we started shipping. Captain Marvel started, to some places. Yeah. But one other thing, if you've missed it on some other figures, I noticed these guys had quite a bit of loose figures. And if you're looking to pick up, and you're not too fussed about packaging, which particularly for some international peeps, some of you are. If this page will load, it's my browser here. I think because we're recording the video, it's a bit slow. But there you go. Lots of cool, already discounted brand new figures. So a $10.99 for the Spidey, $15.99 for the Silver Sable, so forth, so on. There's a lot of loose figures at very good prices. A couple of the Hydra soldiers. That's a bargain. So, yeah, check them out if you want to pick up some loose figures, if loose is your thing.
And I'd just say, because it worked for me, keep an eye on the dark side loose figures, because
it's for you. That's right.
It'll just pop up like I got the one. I got the Gwen and the Miles Spider-Man two packers, two loose figures, and they weren't being sold as package figures. They're just loose ones. I don't know why and whatever else, but I think Spider-Gwen's still there. But, you know, you'll just find little bargains that aren't available as packed. So check both options. I think I got a Luke Cage, a Spider-Gwen, and a Miles. And, you know, I wanted the Miles and Spider-Gwen, which we can't get here, or it's going to cost us $120 or some crap if we go from eBay and stuff. So, and then the Luke Cage pack we didn't get here, and I wasn't really after Claire, so it just it works perfectly.
It does. The one other thing they did have as well was a lot of the stock for Archive arrived damaged, and rather than negotiate with Hasbro, they put up non-mint, they called it, basically. It flew out the door because I think it was a good $20. It's basically you were getting a figure free for ordering a set. So it was a pretty good deal. So it went within a day. I think it was like $60 for four figures, 60, 62 or something, with free shipping in the US anyway, or roughly something like that. So yeah, some good deals. So definitely keep an eye on the page. It doesn't always go with the social media poster when Matt and I see it. So yeah, follow them for sure, or keep a look on the page. Talking about loose figures, another segue there. See what I'm doing? Popped up throughout the week, one of the fairly popular-ish but slightly junky sellers on eBay. I'm not even going to pronounce that. Yak something. Who has often sold a lot of kind of figures that are a bit odd, a bit strange. Some aren't quite legit. That Red Hulk, for example, is not the exactly proper Red Hulk bath that it was. This is a kind of bootleg one. So some of these are bootleg-ish, some of them are just factory runs, as you'll see in a minute, but there was a few interesting figures turned up here in the week. They're probably sold out now, but we'll know them when we see them in just a sec. I bet they've gone. They've gone. Well, there's one there, the Kree Sentry, which is not even out yet, and that appeared up on the site, as did Hercules, which went for crazy money. It was a good $70 the last time I looked at it, just for a loose figure that's not even out yet, just to get it first. My God, there's just so many people are just so desperate to be first with something. It's just
this happened painful. A lot back in like 2015, just before Force Awakens, or when the Force Awakens figures, when the Stormtroopers all of a sudden became available on these sites.
Mm-hmm.
And they were going for stupid prices, and then figures kept leaking out of Hong Kong. And there was a shop, I can't remember who it used to be.
Tong Hori?
No, it was a different one.
Viper's Kingdom?
Viper's Kingdom.
Viper's Kingdom, yeah, they've always had.
And it's just disappeared from the Star Wars world of first figures, and need that one for $120 when it's going to be $20 in 3 weeks' time.
No, it's nuts. There's definitely a bunch of people out there with more money than sense, and just they will kill to have figures first. And yeah, whatever. I'm quite happy to just wait, you know, reasonable amounts of time to post the things. That's not really the end of the world for me. Let's talk about jazz hands, or jazz ink dioramas. You know a little bit more than I do, but this came to my attention this week. Couple of people on Twitter highlighted to me, but tell us what you know about these guys.
Look, I know that they they have previously specialized in 12-inch dioramas, and that could be things like the Bespin I don't know what you call it, the Bespin walkway or whatever, the Bespin balcony or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, I know what you mean.
That thing. Different, different 12-inch things, and their most popular 12-inch diorama was the Blockade Runner, pictured here. So they've now, they're in prototype stage of the 6-inch version, and it looks really good.
It does look really good, doesn't it?
They're, I don't think they're gauging interest. They're moving forward with it, but they're starting to open up for pre-orders, and they're just going through that process now, I think March, April, I'm not sure. They're going to be looking to get these out, and it's really impressive. It's really cool, and it's what you and I have been talking about since San Diego 2017 when they did those 40th anniversary dioramas, and that is the GTP space walls are incredible and they're awesome, and you can customize them and make them and everything else. But there's things like the Blockade Runner here, or the Death Star detention cells, or whatever it is. There is room for more dioramas, and we know that Hasbro is not going to make them. They're going to give us things like this,
which are terrible.
Just a segment of a diorama, or a hill of Acto or whatever it is,
with figures we can't really, they're not even figures.
So these things are great for shelves, they're great for toy photography, and you know, I want to see a lot more dioramas in 2019, 2020, if not from Hasbro, from people like GDP or
Jumping. It's definitely moving on that way. A lot of people are really very creative in doing this. A friend of mine who used to be, and still does actually, the Budget Jedi, who did a lot of 3.75-inch dioramas way back in the day when I was first on YouTube. And he was just, he's amazing of coming up with dioramas out of nothing and making them look wonderful. And but this is now a whole other level. It's like that this is a really high quality, high production value. And this could work for both A New Hope and Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah.
You know, the Tantive IV tunnel as such. But, yeah, it just looks really nice. Reminds me of Rancho Obi-Wan has this little piece in there. They've basically built the tunnel on there, and Steve Sansweet does these things as you go through the little thing. And that's exactly what it reminds me of. I'm waiting for him to jump out, and it's really nicely done. Very, very nicely done.
And we've got everything we need now. We've got Stormtroopers, we've got Vader, we've got New Hope Leia, we've got Rebel Troopers.
Exactly.
Yeah, and look, my thing with this too is check out what Jazz Inc. are doing. Keep across where they're at with this diorama, because my point is if this works for them, they've obviously got the ability to scale down what they've already made. So there could be the Empire balconies, the Bespin balconies, or all these other ones they've made for 12-inch could become available. And I think, you know, if you're not our mate Jay Bud Futu, who can build their own and put their own on the shelves, then the ability for someone else to build really quality dioramas for you is awesome for shelf display, let alone toy photography.
I mean, these are 12-inch. No, and that's 1/6, isn't it?
Yeah, that's 12-inch. 1/6.
Yep.
So yeah, these, like, I mean, if it works for the Blockade Runner hallway to get these kind of things in 6-inch, at all, we've got the figures for it.
Yeah, I know. I think it's something for Hasbro that there's clearly a cost implication. These are not cheap to make, these things. There's a lot of time and effort and energy goes into it, and Hasbro just often don't see the play value. And I think also have enough data to know that these things don't make. It's like the barge, unless it's supported from a kind of fan community. And really, when you think about it, the barge in production terms, that's a very small production run for a toy. It's not huge. What was it, 5,000, I think it was?
No, it had to get to 5,000. They got to 6,000.
But what I'm saying is it's not 25,000, 100,000 of a Barbie doll, a Chewie mask. It's just not got that scale. So you need something like this or like the Barge, I think, to kind of crowdfund and really understand that these things take a lot of time and effort to build, and it's not a cheap thing. It's not really a toy. It's something a bit more precise and takes a lot more effort. Whereas the centerpieces we discussed just didn't do it. Just a bit too cheap and just not quite right, I don't think.
It's not complete enough. It was like just to give a segment. And, you know, I actually think if you look at those three, what were they, Last Jedi exclusive figures, which was Luke at Acto, apparently Rey on Crait with a scene that had no meaning, and Kylo with the throne room floor. Throne room floor was okay, clicked into Snoke's throne. I think Luke's one was really good because you could actually set that up on the ground on a cliff area and cheat the photo and display.
Yep, you could, yep.
But the Crait one was ridiculously stupid.
Yeah, it wasn't good.
Like, you may as well have just put lots of rocks in there.
I know.
Rocks, but Rey's not on Crait. She's not on any red salt, and there is no real fighting on the ground of Crait, and we don't have any troopers or anything else to look at it, look over it. It's like,
yep,
it was just for the sake of it kind of thing, and it's pointless.
Yeah, and that's the thing I think that's annoying is they made that huge lump of plastic with Rey for that. I mean, just don't do it. Give us something else rather than...
Well, technically, they could have just given us the throne room again, another piece to snap onto the throne room.
It's true.
Then...
A battle down with Praetorian or something.
Anyway, the trailers revealed that there was that she was in the throne room with Kylo Ren when she had the red lightsaber and stuff. So
yeah,
it wasn't a pure choice. Spoiler.
Yes, well... Yeah, more dioramas. It's what we want. It's what we want. That's pretty much the main kind of news. However, the good and juicy part is yet to come. If you somehow have been just born or living on another planet, Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries is where you need to really be on your phone. With good reason, there's 103,000 other people out there and a host of really good toy photographers, including lots of stuff that we cover on this show as well. I mean, look at some of these photographs from the talents out there. I have to click on this first. It's Boba. What an amazing shot. Visual force. That is so flipping perb. Wow. Never seen this guy before, I don't think. I don't recall.
No, you would have. We've done it a lot of times.
Wow. Didn't recognize the name.
Beautiful. You can go to his page and see the behind-the-scenes shot of this photo. So
I think this is it. Yep, Visual Force. Gotta get my follow. I'm sorry I wasn't following you, mate, but yeah, wow. We got our Scarif Troopers in every episode so far. Nice. Very cool. Some good stuff on there. So yes, lots and lots of cool stuff, just as we mentioned, the Jazz Ink dioramas. Grey hair Han Solo. Nice. That's pretty good. Boba, as we mentioned. Wow, that's a great shot. That's really cool.
That's featuring a custom Gonk droid from Hammerfall.
So it is. So it is.
Also, yeah, it's, look, I think a Gonk droid, that's what I think should be in the Amazon droid pack. I know it's not. You want me to buy a 3-pack of droids and you want me to buy a 3rd pack of them? Put a Gonk in there. I don't really care what the other two are.
It's just very, very nicely weathered troopers. I think they're all actually sand troopers with, yes, they are. And I think that's why, because the sand troopers, the early sand troopers were always really nicely weathered. That's one that is definitely going to be an archive, is the sand trooper. Yeah.
Put in a black pauldron sand trooper, if not an orange one. They should just actually put a sand trooper and just put a black pauldron on it and put an orange one and a white one in there as well and just watch everyone buy. They could do a solid case of
sand. I know, just sand troopers. I know. That would be so strong. Exactly. I love that one. That was really nice. Light it up. From BLK series. Very, very nice indeed. A lot of time went into that photograph.
And again, if you go to Zay's page, you can see the behind the scenes video of that as well. So
nice.
It's you know, whatever you look on my page, I'll share sometimes the BTS segments and stuff, but always visit the artist page if you want to see how it's done.
That is nuts. All that work and fireworks, not to be recommended easily, kids. Oh, he's doing, that's a different shot, but still, you can see the, yeah, that's what he was doing for his bumblebee picture.
Is it, if you go up to the, does that one slide over? Or is it, no, it's the one, it's the picture to its left.
Oh, that's, there we go, there we go. So again, fireworks.
It's just a garden.
Bit of smoke.
Atmosphere.
Some kind of firework off. And I guess he's obviously doing a bit of manipulation with the photograph afterwards to take the wires out.
Yeah.
Nice. God, the work and time and detail that goes into that. But then look at the shot you get.
Yeah.
That's awesome. So good. Light it up. Very, very talented bunch. Very, very. Why am I not following this guy? Never mind. I'm terrible on social channels these days. I'm so lazy. You're definitely the Instagram king. Let's go back here. So stunning again, as usual, as always. And again, another one, Gregory Titus. Great artwork for the Patrol Trooper from Solo.
So yeah, as you know, I like to do things in threes, and I've been sitting on two waiting for a third to come through. And this morning, Greg shared his General Grievous, which allowed me to get Patrol Trooper and Skiff Guard Lando up. So
nice. Beautiful artwork. How good is that? That's really, really nice. Love a little album of his artwork. It'd be so cool. Look at that. What? That's stunning. Wow.
And again, I'll just say, like the toy photographers, I share the image. I have a little comment in there sometimes and my thoughts or whatever it is. But visit Greg's page, follows Greg's page, get his insight into the art he's doing that, you know, Grievous was a pleasure because he didn't have to go into the arms and the body and everything that goes with it.
Yep. Superb. Some other stuff I haven't really seen. You, it's only when you see it up close to this that you really appreciate the artwork that he's done for it. Because it's kind of hidden on the box and it doesn't really show off as much as... wow. Going down a rabbit hole there. We won't go there anymore. Back to you. What else do we have? Let's go click through here because there's so much stuff we could be here all night, but let's click through. Wow, I love the daylight in that shot. That's just so realistic looking, the lighting on it. Wow. Sand Troopers, again, just gently weathered with some nice diorama pieces, looking good. Wow, Mimbins. Still far too weathered for me, Mimbins. They're just, I don't know, doesn't quite work.
If they're going to be dirty and muddy, they're going to be really dirty and muddy.
Yeah, I know, but something about them isn't quite right. Dengar, looking good. Still a great figure. Really, really good, good figure. That's a nice shot. I think from the, it's kind of replicating the Force Unleashed, I think.
No, no, it's the closing scene of Rogue One.
Oh, of course it is. Of course it is.
This is a Rogue One triple from a new account I found on Toy Tribe. I was following it on Toy Tribe for obviously a non-Star Wars reason. And these three Vader picks just hit me and I was like, oh, it's going to get a triple.
Definitely. Andreas Warmaster. Oh, lovely. Wow. Very nice indeed. God, it's just the effort and the work. It's just beautiful. And again, there's still a lot of people, I've seen a lot of people say, oh, how can I get a toy photography? Or, oh, my shots aren't as good. Just practice. You can see these guys are out just doing, they're trying things. And I think that's, and they're just then looking through maybe 20, 30 shots and picking one of the best ones and maybe a tweak here and there and boom, they got it. But this is a good one. Bear Trap, looking good with the poncho. Very nice. A little bit of Bosk there with some twin sons. That looks like he's looking on a PC screen or something, I think, behind him.
Yeah, it'll be some kind of, what do they call it? Digirama.
Digirama. Nice, from 1975. That's still looks good, though. Twin Suns. Very nice. Bit of Darth Revan. Very nice indeed. Oops, I skipped one there. Little Yoda. A custom Yoda. Thank goodness we're getting a new Yoda very shortly. That's pretty nice. The gang's all here. The 6-inch with their mini counterparts. Look at Bosk. He's quite happy. Very, very cool. God, these original figures. Oh, the fun I had with them. Never mind. Another nice Boba shot from the Imperial Grunt. Looks like the same diorama we saw earlier on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But again, the beauty of the archive wave is all these great accounts that didn't have the figures are now getting their shot at it.
Exactly. A nice Luke crate going on there, I think. And that's a really nice angle they've done there of the Luke figure. The one I like, you never liked that figure, but I do. We've covered before Three Lizzie. But what a really nice angle and shot with the foreground with the evaporator, which I guess will be the 3.75-inch evaporator there.
Could be, or it could be one of the customs. It could, I don't know, but I know that Figureworks Custom does a 6-inch one, so...
Oh, right, true.
I'm not sure which one it is, but it's all working to perfect kind of scale, whichever one it is.
Very nice indeed. Force Awakens, great looking shot. Very tasty indeed. Again from Three Lazy. What else we got there? That's the... Is that the archive?
No, just the...
Is that the regular?
The regular.
I was going to say, because it looks a little different there, but it's the way the light's reflecting off him. But yeah, it's got a cape. Yeah, not too bad. It's not too shabby. Sweat picks. There we go. Is that the Jazz?
No, that is a printed on paper background.
Wow. Okay, that looks absolutely fantastic. Great job there, Warfels. Very good job indeed. And there's some other little... photos in there. Nice. Foul stench as I came on board. Very nice indeed. A great shot. Nice. Now look at the difference in them there. That looks like the original Han. Yep, that's all the new ones. A custom Yoda, I think. God, that Bespin look needs a upgrade.
It does, and that's why I'm like, you know, the body's great and fine and looks good. The head just is so out of whack, and a repaint will help it, but it's not going to fix it.
Yeah.
And this is where it's kind of like, you're not going to re-release it as number 111 or whatever, so break that rule and give it a new head, and you'll sell a whole lot of heap of units if you nail the head with the photo reel and give us the equivalent of what you've done with Han Solo.
Yep.
You will sell a new Luke to everybody.
Exactly. GP Lavanda visit his page. Very cool shot. Got some nice trippers and moody, broody black and white there from Corona 4.
There's been a black and white, not challenge, but a tagging challenge. I guess it's not really winner takes all kind of thing, but a black and white challenge going on at the moment, which has been kind of good to follow.
Cool. And what tag is the...
I don't know if I'm using it in that. They're all hashtagging each other in it, and it's Star Wars.
All you mind. Kids with your hashtags. The Geek Nick looking very good there. Putting their God, you put your wolf into the dirty water. Ugh. Anyway, good on you for doing that. Such a good figure. This one I remember seeing and just thinking, Jesus, what a shot this was. Will Candy Toy Photography, beautifully done. Absolutely beautiful done, but kind of simple in its premise when you think about it, the reflection shot. But a really, really beautifully done shot. I just remember seeing that on my phone. I just thought, oh, wow, that is just outstanding. There you go. I liked it then as well. The Han, that is actually quite a good figure, but a lot of people don't like him. Chubakuki, very nice username. Forlorn from Mr. Gizmo. I like that. Pardon me, that one too. Very, very nice indeed. Rio Durant offering Krispy Kreme by the looks of it.
Yeah.
Yum, yum. And lots of patrol troopers. I love the angles of the heads. They genuinely look quite, what's this? This is so well done. So well done. How to Bribe the Patrol Troopers. Very, very cool indeed. And that's from Todd Hoffer. What have we got here at Leia? Yes, very nice. This archive look is not looking good. So
that is a slightly improved head, though, which so in the sense of compared to what it comes out of the packet, this is Foolish Robo, and he's put whatever I've put in there, the matte paint over it to take the gloss off it. And once you take the gloss shine off it, it looks better than what it was looking like before the gloss. It's just too glossy from what I can see. And this is matted it up a little bit. I still think the first, till I get mine, I won't know, but the first figure is still the best.
Absolutely. I can't believe that they didn't quite improve upon the first release, but anyway.
But yeah, trust me. Well, not trust me. The gloss makes it a better version of what feels like a worse version.
Interesting. Time will tell. More troopers looking good. Bud Futu, nice little touches there on the snow trooper with just the lights and a different blaster. Looks very tasty indeed. Otis Williams photography, but a wolf, such a great figure. That was a little bit of news this week. I think I saw a couple of places got them pretty cheap in the UK, or was it here in Australia as well? I think we saw some in Australia. There was a couple of places managed to get them. Yeah, I saw some. It was about 40 Australian, which is about
39 bucks, and I'm trying to think who it was.
I think it was that Alliance group or something. Somebody posted. Anyway, Wolf seems to be doing the runs, and someone in the UK as well had mentioned that Wolf had been at some store, so there must have been some available somehow. More Scarif Troopers looking very good indeed. Oh, there's a Bobo we missed. That's awesome. I've actually got that piece of fabric cape. It was from eBay quite some time ago, but very nice Proto Fett looking. Very cool pose, has to be said. As we said, Scarif Troopers with Han Solo looking great. Such a cool wave, that wave. It really still is. Very nice looking kind of use for your Luke Skywalker poncho for a trooper, and again nice angles from Dank Studios. Very dank indeed. Nice moody broody Sabine. I'm thinking of Sabrina. Oh, look at that shot, that's superb. Shingu, the Tobias Beckett figure. I was showing that to my wife the other day. Actually, I was saying, hey, that Tobias Beckett figure, look, who is this? And she was like, my god, that's Woody Harrelson. So that's stunning.
There's no mistaking it.
There's no mistake. It's such a good figure in terms of facial lightness. Yeah, there we go. There's the figure. So we've got the copper Duracell IG-88, and that face so far.
So that was the shiny face, I think, compared to the matte face.
Ay, ay, ay. Not great. There we get another shot from JP Lavanda. Just again, just different bunch. There's a head swap on Han. There's
a repaint of Chewie. There's a head swap on Leia. There's the cut face.
So it is. Yep.
And Luke is the Obi-Wan body trimmed down and repainted and with a new head. But it's, you know, not Soft Goods, A New Hope, Luke. And it's actually the Obi-Wan body, I think.
Wow. That's a lot of work went into that. Jeez.
We go back to JP. I haven't shared it yet, but have a look at his Return of the Jedi set of customs. So click on his account.
Let's have a look. Oh, very nice. Wow. He's done a shot of three. Wow. A wicket too. Very cute. Yeah, he's cut the face off. Yeah, I see what you're saying. Wow. Nice touch, even the look. The Lando as well. Oh my god, what a bunch of work to go through for figures that I guess you'll probably maybe get in a year or so. Wow, that is effort. Would not have been me. Very nice though. Love and effort went into that, that is for sure. Damn. That's what we talked about earlier on in the show. Kylo sitting there from Swift Picks. It is a good throne. What we got going on here? Oh, that's amazing. That's very well done. I've seen some people do that before, that perspective kind of shot. Wow. Okay. That's nice. Kylo, cutscene from The Force Awakens, work more or less, looking very good. Shot of Dengar looking good. IG with a little bit of custom. That's so nicely done. Just the kind of lighting on there as well. Good job shooting the galaxy. And that's a cracker of Bosky Bosk outdoors. A little bit of CGI snow, I think, by the looks of it.
Yeah.
I guess it's when... Go ahead.
Bosk getting some archive love from new accounts who didn't have him previously.
Yeah, that's true. That is very, very true. New look. Still not feeling it, but never mind. We'll find out in time. Shooting the galaxy. Nice shot from him. And a nice shot of 3PO getting his oil bath. Thank the maker. We talked about Grievous. More explosions and troopers. Always a staple diet of the toy photographers. A nice simple shot, but that really works actually from the First Order Elite. Really good looking figure, actually. Just he's so black, it's very hard to see some of the detail on him. More troopers, move along. Another nice shot, Stormtrooper Pete there. Lovely lighting there in the red and the blue. That's very nice indeed. Oh, I just love these guys. I really wish they came with the proper guns, though. It's beginning to really annoy me that they did not. I've seen quite a couple of really good customs of these guys. They've just tweaked the paint beautifully and just brought out, again, what is there, the sculpt. So a nice job again. The Chip Monsters. Never grow tired of looking at Mr. Fett. Abraham 98. More of the Inferno Squad. Is that Inferno Squad? That's not
Inferno. Yeah, it is.
Is it?
Yeah, Black TIE Fighters with the red.
Okay. Oh, gotcha, good. Oh, okay. Something's tweaked there or something. Nice little Ahsoka as she walks by. Choke some hover tank pilots. Wow, that's a 6-inch figure. Damn. Nice touch up on the photograph, though, with the lights. Very, very cool. Yeah, it does look like a classic 80s album. I like that a lot. Is that the new archive look?
Maybe? Yeah, that's the new look. But, you know, with the helmet, there's no issue.
The helmet, it looks much better. Looks way better. Interesting. Let's just make sure where we're going here. Just want to get to your Toy Tribe page as well. Bosk, very nice. Nice bit of shot of Lando. That, is that a custom head? No.
No.
Such a good figure, though. Still really, as you, we said, in our top tens. It's definitely a very good figure. Mandalorian underscore photographer, looking good there. Great looking figures from Solo, as usual. Still some strange people out there who have not seen Solo and yet they say they're big Star Wars fans. What are you doing? Bud Fudu, what's going on? He's moving. Got to put this in storage, isn't that right?
He's moving, putting it in storage. So this was the last hurrah of the greatest shelf in our community.
Shelf porn. That's exactly right. That's just so good. Yes, good luck to him and his travels, whatever he's doing, and we'll see it coming back soon. Nice, simple shots, a lot of these, and not overly complicated, but just shows you can still get some great shots just with...
That yellow, whatever trooper the yellow one is, captain, commander, whatever, looks like it's straight out of Clone Wars, the animation.
I know, it does, actually. Just the way that lighting's just really hit the corner of it. Very nice indeed. Oh, is this a... What was it? The
Bird Box?
Netflix movie, Bird Box. Yeah.
I still haven't watched it, but no, I got it straight away.
Very cool. Maul with, I think, a custom head?
No, I don't know.
Is that the original?
It's got the round, annoying round horns.
Oh, lots of peeps. Nice picture. Nice angle. It just looks very moody, broody of him. Some really good poses there. Gun poses with the troopers. And that's a beauty there with the twin sons.
Yeah.
Absolutely gorgeous. Very, very nice indeed. Just dead creative.
I like the one next to it.
This trooper here? Oh, banging his head. Very nice indeed. What's going on here with 2019?
That was the new year.
Oh, so it was. Wow. Dope. Well, that's probably a good time to...
Yeah, so what follows below that, between our show and that, is I went through, and I've got to say, I said at the beginning, I had to go through like 2,500 or 3,000 images, or 2,500 images that were shared in 2018. And last year I called them the best of 2017. And this year I think it was just highlights, because it's not the best. I missed like some of it's the best. Sure. It's what I like as a personal highlights from what I've seen as I'm flicking through 2,000 images.
Yep.
Trying to save them again. And I missed a heap of great images. I missed a heap of great accounts. But, you know, it's Instagram can crash when you're flicking through 2,000.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Go all the way back again. And, you know, I missed a heap. I know I missed a heap. I might try and do it differently this year by at the end of each month, just filing away my favorite from January, my favorite from February. And try and keep a live tally going. But, yeah, it's always at the end of the year I'll go through and find what my favourites of the year are, or from what I see my favourites.
Mm.
But, yeah, that was what was between the show and the new year, our show and the new year.
And there was a lot of good stuff. There really was. I mean, it's not easy to pick some of the best photography when even every time we do a show, maybe once every 2 or 3 weeks, there's always stunning photographs. So you're just drowning in stuff. But it's a good bunch of toy photographers out there. So one of Matt's other accounts is ToyTribe, Instagram.com/ToyTribe for his kind of non-Star Wars stuff. But some good memes and images and other stuff you've curated again throughout the internet there. This Popeye, is it SH Figure Arts, I think?
Mezco.
Mezco is doing the rounds. Doesn't do it for me, but seems to be doing it for some others. But yeah, I like the meme effect there, the whole Drake thing going on. And who is this? What is that? Ray?
That's Ray, yeah.
Wow. What a great pose. And the little porg. Up in the background there. I like that. Nice little touch. Still don't understand Dragon Ball. I don't get the whole crazy hair thing. I don't get it either.
But
I don't get it. So there you go. Someone's watching. Explain, what's the big deal with these dudes' hair? Everybody's get wild, gelled up, moosed up, blow-dried hair before they go into battle and kick each other's ass. What is going on with the hair?
I think that's what happens when you've got a lot of power.
Yeah, I guess. It's just bizarre. I don't get it. More of the Popeye with some 6-inch size.
So Mezco, interestingly, and I wasn't aware of it until after the fact, and as you know, in Australia, we're a day ahead, so it's on the 13th that I miss everything that was happening in America on the 12th, but it was the 1st of January, 1/12, so it was 1/12 day. So Mezco started a 1/12 day kind of tag thing going of, do your six inch figure shots. So that was a big boost on, I think it was Saturday or whatever it was, of 6-inch photos popping up everywhere.
Cool. Here's the classic Mezco Iron Man you were talking about. And it's pretty beautiful looking. They've done a nice job.
It's got a light in there.
I think the difference is really nice is Hasbro and others just made this out to be soft material, like as if it was just muscle.
Yeah.
Like he was wearing yellow
tights
or something. It was just, and it always looked really crap, but that's a really nice touch on that figure. Very nice. Good job, Mezco. That's really impressive, that suit. No wonder it's doing the rounds. Very, very cool. What else do we have on your page? We want to talk about Fortnite. We'll be there all day. Black Panther is shipping, which is good. Oh, who actually got this? Please don't tell me you bought this. No, you didn't buy it. Yeah. Someone else. Hunted for this for long enough, and of all the places you could buy it, so expensive now. So, such a shame. Such a shame they had to keep it limited. Lovely shot there. Wolverine and Hulk getting some dental work. Looks good. I love the blood they've got going on there. That's superb.
And a little bit of Photoshop to fix up those butterfly eyes of Wolverine, but it looks awesome.
It does. It looks really, really nice. Very, very cool indeed. As is that shot there. Hadouken. Street Fighter 2. Very nice indeed. I love this kid because there's loads of other things that you generally wouldn't see. You're coming with me, Creeps. This is the Hot Toys, I think.
No,
this is this new Mayfix. Yeah. Wow, that is pretty awesome. This was one expensive figure, though. This was 120.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, it was expensive as F. It really was. I highly recommend the NECA figure. It's probably only about $30 now, but it's a very cheap alternative to this figure. Because I don't have that amount of money. Nice custom. Is this for real?
Yeah, no, it's custom.
I was going to say it's a custom.
Products, and I think there's a holiday special behind it as well.
That would be a nice, easy one for them to do.
Yeah.
Good God. They got to do that. Oh, wow. Easy peasy. Get on it, Disney. Yeah, this line is one that I've been really getting into, especially in the Marvel side of things. Very impressive once you get them in hand. So well worth checking out. Skrulls, that's a nice pick.
Somebody's bought a lot of them
already. Yeah, jeez, Skrulls fans. El Sinestro, very good job on the photography there. The Spider-Man Noir Marvel Legends looks lovely. What's going on here with the Super 7 stuff?
It's just the new wave of He-Man, Wave 4.
And, oh, yeah, we covered it.
You know, my thing with that is I loved Stratos as a figure and the cartoons and everything, and I love the Filmation figures, but this is one where the loyalty to the cartoon just made a crap figure.
Mm.
I mean, the Classics version is so awesome, and they can make such a weird-looking dude look so cool, but I guess when you're being true to the cartoon, he just looks... He looks silly.
Mm. Have you ever seen, Rick and Morty, the show?
Yeah, I've tried many a time.
Oh, my God. Well, anyway, one of the characters in it is Gearhead, and I think this is the inspiration for him. I didn't realize until I saw this. Bit of Supes, bit of Spidey, bit of the Deadpool Marvel Legends, that Bumblebee photograph, which we saw earlier on. Just, again, the work that went into that, but the effect, wow. What Bumblebee is that?
Click on his page and he says that it's not the new one that's coming out yet. It's one of the older ones.
Bumblebee.
There we go.
Takara Tomy, so it'll be a Japanese one. Okay, I'd imagine $70, $80 or something. It's not going to be cheap. Stunning looking figure, though. Wow. Just looks fantastic. I think the effect of the eyes just brings it home in the weathering. It's really, really nice.
Yeah.
I could get into Transformers if it looked that good. Back to Toy Tribe. Just a few more. If there's any you want to call out, say. But
what was next to Bumblebee? Sorry, up a little. There's Dorkler's Iron Man shot, but it just...
highlights again how good it is.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Secret Wars Iron Man.
Yes. Joker? It's not a. Is that a figure? Damn. Yeah. Very nice animated style. Lots of cool stuff. Turtles. I have no idea who this guy is.
That's been Gene Oakland. He used to be the announcer and interviewer for the WWF, and he passed away, whatever. Week or two ago, and that was his figure back in the day.
Gotcha. That is one of my favorite figures, the Samuel L. Jackson Pulp Fiction. It's a very cool figure indeed. This is a tasty burger. Very nice. Is this you? Oh, you got your
Astro Boy. That's how
Astro Boy. Yes, that was your Christmas present, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Christmas present to you. Kingpin from Darkseid and some other places, I think that is. Yep. Darkseid Warehouse. Nice. Looking pretty good.
That was a Old Boys Hulk sculpt head for the SH figure arts Hulk.
I did see that, but it did nothing for me.
Look, it just depends if you like that version of Hulk. Like, Hulk's had so many different heads.
I know.
It's not personally for me either, but heck, if you wanted, I want to see them do a McFarlane head Hulk.
Yeah, that'd be different. That would be different. But this head is terrifying in all the right ways. I do not like this head. Yes, I agree. I do not like this head either. And that takes us back to Christmas time, I think. Follow Matt, Instagram.com/ToyTribe, and also Star Wars The Black Series, as well as some other stuff that he does too. Anything else you want to talk about, Reese, that I've missed or we didn't get in the notes or we didn't cover? Or
I don't think so. I think that's everything for this week. It's January. Cool. Not much going on.
January, there's not much going on. We've got Toy Fair coming up in literally 4 weeks.
Yeah.
We've got some pre-orders coming up pretty soon as well.
What can they announce at New York for Star Wars?
Say that again, sorry?
What could they announce at New York? Because they've already announced everything till June. They're not going to run. They can only announce their September wave, which because they're not going to announce their October episode 9
stuff. Yep.
So my backing is the Phantom Menace 20th anniversary cards. Back to the fact that it was New York Toy Fair that they announced out of nowhere the 40th anniversary wave 1 and wave 2, and they're separate. They were. Whatever they called them, wave 1 and wave 2, they weren't a part of, they weren't wave 15 and 16. They were a separate wave. So
yep.
I think we'll get Phantom Menace vintage carded figure announcement, which will be some repacks and some new figures.
Not sure about the actual vintage style on that card, but time will tell.
Yeah, I think we'll get the vintage.
I don't know what's going on, but I think there may be some celebration-like style things going on with the Phantom Menace that may be something quite different. I don't know. I don't think it's quite what you and I think, but time will tell. Time will tell.
4 weeks.
Exactly. So we'll know. We'll know soon enough. So, yeah. But definitely going to be, as you said, a Phantom Menace kind of heavy year to celebrate that movie, so expect lots of Maul, I would imagine, in every shape, size, and form. But I think we may even get a little tease of a vehicle, maybe a smaller vehicle again. There's a few out there that they could do.
Remember that, the 375?
They could be doing some multi-packs again. We haven't seen any of them in quite a while. Some exclusive stuff now that they've kind of sorted out some things with some partners. Maybe things have found a home. Don't know. There's quite a few things that I'm kind of in the dark as to what they're doing, but they had a very busy year this year with all the cons, all the releases, and it felt like tons of stuff. We were always seeing stuff at every different show, which I think was a really good success. But yeah, I guess there's a lot more to be found out, but leave a note or comment. What do you want to see? New York Comic Con is literally weeks away. So leave a note and say, I want these three things. And we'll tell you what we think too. Okay, I think that is number 35 in the can. So thank you, everybody who watches, joins, follows Matt's pages, all the toy photographers and everybody. We really appreciate you watching. If you like it, give it a thumbsy uppy and share it around. And it helps to spread the word, and we get some nice toy photographers and other things out there that we help spread the word on them. It's about them too. So yeah, check it out, and we'll see you for number 36 coming up soon.
See ya.